And when we feel the Holy Spirit, when we pray for people, don't think about how come this person hasn't experienced the Holy Spirit. Don't think about that. It's God's work. We just do our part. We just bless the person. Let God do His work. We don't have to think about the result. What happens? We just pray for the person and just enjoy the process. So when I pray for people, I will just do this. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. And I just enjoy the process. And I don't look at just falling down. Actually, the key to experience the Holy Spirit is not falling down. Some people fall down. It's good. And when they feel the power of God and just relax and fall down, some people immediately experience joy or love, or some people go to heaven. And not to die, but to come back. You know, go to the soul, go to heaven and come back. When they relax and let the power come to them. But if they don't fall down, it doesn't matter. The key, when I pray for people, is that they'll pay attention to the peace inside. To the release of burden. To the comfort to the body. And remember that. Now, what's the biblical basis for that? That actually the Bible has many support verses that I can tell you. How we can experience the Holy Spirit. First, I want to say this. The work of the Holy Spirit in the Bible may not just say Holy Spirit. When Jesus said, I'll do this to you, it's also the work of the Holy Spirit. Because Father, Son, and Holy Spirit work together. So when the Bible says, Jesus said, I'll give you peace, the Holy Spirit will give us peace too. So these five verses are going to write down. Isaiah 61, 1-3. It talks about He will heal the brokenhearted. He will proclaim freedom for the captives, release from darkness, to comfort all who mourn. And then oil of gladness instead of mourning. So He will bring inner healing. So when people experience that, I will tell them, this is promised in the Bible. God will heal the brokenhearted. Now this you can write down, because this will be used for evangelism or for uplifting the spiritual life of people. So when I pray for people, I look for this. And I ask them, did you experience any, did you experience anything? And they say, oh, I feel peaceful. And then I'll tell them, John 14:27. Peace I leave with you, and peace I give you. Many people feel peace. And what person I pray for? After I finished praying, I asked her, what's your experience? She said, oh, you're still here. I said, where do you think I've gone? I've been praying for you. She said, I went to another place. I thought, I'm alone there. She didn't realize I'm still there praying for her. Then she went to a different place, to heaven. That she experienced a great peace. That is a very common experience. And also Matthew 11:28, come to me all you who are weary and burdened, and I'll give you rest. So the Holy Spirit will bring, take away the burdens. Burdens go away. And in Psalm 16, first Romans 5:5, the Holy Spirit will pour the love of God into our hearts. Romans 5:5. So some people experience the love of God. And then, Psalm 16:8-9. In verse 9 it says that my heart is glad, my tongue rejoices, and my body also will rest secure. That there will be comfort to the body. The soul will rejoice and comfort to the body. And many people said they feel peace. They feel comfort to the body. They feel relaxed. And I prayed for one drug addict. And he said to me, when you pray for me, I felt more comfort than when I took drugs. That comfort to the body. That many people, they are in sickness. I pray for people with chemotherapy. And they were suffering with pain. And then after prayer, it said, I feel comfort to the body. And so this is something we can do. Have confidence. But when people say they don't experience anything, it's okay. We can put down our pride. It doesn't matter. If we pray for someone that said, I don't experience anything, it's okay. And so, Psalm 4:8, I will lie down and sleep in peace, for you alone, O Lord, make me dwell in safety. So here is talking about sleeping in peace. Now, I help many people with insomnia. I said, if you have insomnia, stand up and pray for maybe 20, 20 minutes to 30 minutes before you sleep. Because when you stand and relax and pray, you don't have to say anything. Just think of Jesus loves me and I love Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. And your whole body relaxes. That way you can go to sleep easier. And if someone wakes up in the middle of the night and cannot sleep again, then I encourage them to stand up to relax. And then pray, relax. And then when they lie down, they can do this. Oh, Jesus. In the mind, very relaxed. Relax the whole body. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Not to say it out, but in the mind. Jesus, Jesus. Very, very relaxed. And people can go to sleep easier. So if people with insomnia, I pray for many people with insomnia and they immediately sleep better. And then Mark 16, verses 17 and 18, that in signs will follow those who believe. In Jesus' name, they'll cast out demons and they lay hands on the sick and they'll be healed. So this gives us the power of miracles. So all this, these are some of the things that can happen to us when we pray for people. So we ask them, what do you experience? Okay, now, just now, I talked about how we can be filled with the Holy Spirit. I talked about first, repentance, say no to sin. Second, have faith in God. Three, Bible. Four, worship in spirit and truth. Five, obey the Great Commission. Preach the gospel and build our spiritual life for people. And number six, the laying on of hands helps. Because the Bible does talk about that. Paul and Peter laid hands on people and they were filled with the Holy Spirit. So it helps and then it brings healing. So that's why I encourage you to come forward later and then we'll lay hands on you. And you can experience the presence of God. And then every day, then you keep the presence of God. Every day, keep the presence of God. When you come to worship, you keep the presence of God and keep worshiping God in the Spirit. And then you can experience Him every time you pray. And then number seven, take care of different problems in life. Take care of different problems in life. If you have anger, frustration, negative feelings, negative thinking, you won't be filled with the Holy Spirit. If you worry every day, you won't be filled with the Holy Spirit. When I pray, I see a total release of all burdens, that my heart is totally relaxed. Oh, Jesus, you're so wonderful. My heart and my body is totally relaxed when I pray. Ooh, and I enjoy that. It is enjoyable and it brings the presence of God. It's something we need to do every day. Now how do we use that when we pray for people? When I pray for people, I encourage people to open the heart to God and believe that God is going to bless them and relax and think of our spirit comes to God. Oh, Jesus, I need you. Or think of God as a person they really like. I like Jesus. I like Jesus. I thank you, Jesus. That way they can experience the Holy Spirit easier. And just relax. And then for myself, I would think of God more than His problems. I just think of God. And then just relax. And when I lay on people, I don't push. I don't want people to think I push them down. Usually I touch them just with the tip of my fingers. If they about to fall, I put my hand behind them so that they know it's not me who pushed them. It's the power of the Holy Spirit. And during the process, I will love God. I will worship God. I believe that God is loving me. And you can do this training in your church. One key to being filled with the Holy Spirit. But I still want to pray for you. And we'll have a break time. But, you know, some people can go for the break, but some people can stay. But what I want to say is your heart for God. Is your heart for God. Do you want your life to be blessing people? Or do you want just want money? Or do you want just want success in the ministry? Or do you want God's heart? You want to bless people. I hope that you have that heart. I have prayed for tens of thousands of people. I've seen many people, most people, will experience the peace and comfort immediately. That's something we can all have, the anointing. So I'm happy to pray for you, to impart that to you and also to show you how you can keep that. But the most important thing is, do you want to be used by God? Are you willing to give your life to God? Or do you just want that church experience? Or do you want to be used by God to be blessing people? If one person can affect other people, influence other people, then the other people can influence other people, then you will be able to influence many people. You can influence many people in your life. That is God's will, that we can bless many, many, many people in this world. And then Christianity will have a great impact in this world. There's so many good, warm Christians. One spirit-filled Christian who is devoted to the Lord is more powerful than 1,000 lukewarm Christians. So if you are filled with the Holy Spirit and you train people how to serve God, you can have more influence than 1,000 or 10,000 lazy Christians. And I hope that you hunger for God. Do you hunger for God? Let's rise and pray. Oh, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. So we live for you, Tony. One person living for Jesus can have more influence than 1,000 people who are lazy. We can have an influence in the world. Lord Jesus, help us to see the importance of revival. One revived Christian can do great things for God. Lord, help us to be willing. Help us to be willing. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. My life is for you. My life is for you. My life is yours. My money is yours. My time is yours. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let me just hear this last thing I want to say is, when you pray for people, ask them what they experience. Please keep your eyes closed. What have you experienced? And they said, I experienced peace. Burdens go away. And then you say, this is what Jesus said. You give us peace. We take away your burdens. So God has blessed you like this. Do you want Jesus to bless you all your life? And then if he's willing, you bring it to Jesus. So this is my experience God evangelism. You pray for someone, you ask them if they experience anything. If they experience God, then you say, this is what God is telling you. The peace or the comfort or the healing or the joy. And then do you want God to bless you? And then you bring them to Jesus. If it's a Christian, then you say, God has blessed you like this. And you can bless other people too. Do you want to be used by God? Do you want to be blessing other people? So I will do this to non-Christians and to Christians. And at this time, it's your break time, but I hope some of you will hunger for God. I know maybe you have experienced the Holy Spirit sometime, but it's always better to be filled with the Holy Spirit more. It's always good to be filled with the Holy Spirit more. And also, we can have a way to have Holy Spirit party. That everyone, filled with the Holy Spirit. That increase the anointing. So you want to stay, come forward. For the rest, you can go to have a break. Oh.